about to tell you some shit you probably ain't never heard before. I spoke about the I Ching. I spoke about the I Ching. So now I'm going to bring light to that which I said, or that which I spoke about. I wanna, you know what I'm saying? And the key point is that you messing with the I Ching. Is your I Ching, as you getting a reading, is your I Ching practitioner your warrior or your traitor? Because the I Ching is a reading on future events for your benefit, or just future events. So now, who would you want doing that reading? A warrior that stands forth for you, regardless of you, stand forth for your nation. That's how you know it's for you, regardless of the fact. Or some traitor ass. You know what I'm saying? Who is gonna lead you to your downfall? Special reading or not? So now, I'm gonna be real quick with this. I'm not gonna waste no time. The I Ching, as I said, is integral in all things that's referred to as Bagua. A lot of people is on this Oriental kick. Don't even know what a Bagua is. And definitely don't know how far expanding the Bagua is. It's deeper than a yin yang sign. It's deeper than a philosophical conversation about the yin yang sign. And it's definitely deeper than the I Ching. The I Ching don't exist without the Bagua. So, like I said, for those on that Oriental kick, Africa is the one seed. And the Orient is almost like a mirror image of African culture. And that's why a lot of black folks tend to find that amusing. It's because they don't understand that that's African culture too. That's African culture regardless. So since you're too weak to come home to your culture, you're gonna go somewhere else that's doing your culture anyway. So you don't have to bow down to your family. You wanna go to another family to do exactly what your family was doing from the beginning. So I'm gonna show you some things. Because talk all day, but if people ain't showing you some things, it's a little funny there. Can you see that? That's a vortex point, the center of power, and a whole bunch of other things. So now, before I go in right quick, you know what I'm saying, I just wanted to say, as I put this forth, and this is like something you ain't never heard before, understand, no man is the master of my knowledge. I wasn't taught by a man, so I'm not beholden to someone else's rules. The ancestors and the universe put me on. So the ancestors and the universe, you know what I'm saying, is who will put me in place. And then it was followed up after I was taught by the universe, then some human or come forth and give me a little knowledge, this, that, and the third. Just to confirm what I know, not to teach me what I know. And if you think these little seeds is the apex of my knowledge and understanding, you a fool. And if you think the knowledge, the little seeds that you got are so fantastic that you need to cover it and hold and hide them, then you a fool. Because we are far from any true level of human intelligence. So to think anything that you know what I'm saying, is some coveted secret. It's only secret from your own community. Everybody else knows. So why are you hiding from your own family? This is my second book, Internal Martial Arts. Internal Martial Arts, Spiritual Sciences of Sex and the Elements. So you know what I'm saying, if you wanna, first I'm gonna go through these animals right quick. And what I wanna say is, I'm a warrior for my nation. I'm a warrior for my nation, and all things that come out my mouth is in union with the nation being built again. Divine black. No category or no doctrine allowed. Strictly the power of black people. If you want to rep something, you can rep it. But black first. Nature and the elements first. So now, you know what I'm saying, I'll flip through some of these pages and find out what I'm looking for. Just so you can see what it is, you know what I'm saying. Got a lot of pictures in here to understand your power. Oh, okay, right here. This right here is Egyptian artifacts at Muwatta Ashby, showing you the postures and what they was doing. I advise any book. I co-sign any book by Muwatta Ashby. Just know his name and get at him. You don't even have to worry about what book it is. Muwatta Ashby, yeah, that's good. That's a good look. You know what I'm saying? But down here at the bottom, those are all Buddhists or Buddhism. Oriental gods. No. Messing up. Black man is more than God. And God is just a deity. God does not mean deity. So now, those are Oriental deities. And none of them is fat. And none of them is bald-headed. Although I'm sure everybody sees statues of bald-headed Chinese heads and a fat Buddha. No deity whatsoever has a bald head. None of them. They all got the nighty head. All of them. That's black man. All of them. Not one. And none of them have straight lines in it, so it ain't straight head Chinese either. These are postures for power. So that you're the pinnacle, you're the channel of heaven and earth. When you got your body in right order. That's why no deity anywhere in an Oriental understanding do you see is fat. Ganesh is not fat. That's an elephant. And even an elephant is not fat. That's his natural body. And when you look at it, it's not a chubby dude either. So, going to these animals. So now, you got the animals. And it's a 12-year cycle. What I'm gonna speak about is five and a half, which is directly related to black people. The other animals are personalities of the years that come about. And you can start with the dragon represents black people. So now, when you come into that, you want to know the energy of what's coming up before we get into your year, the year of the dragon, the year of black people. So that's, you need to understand the ox transforming into the tiger, which is like a Sekhmet energy, and even Sekhmet is a tiger. So tiger in Oriental theologies and so forth, is Sekhmet. A lion or tiger. See the similarities of the picture? The tiger transforming into the rabbit, or transitioning. They unfold. All of these are personalities that happen after one personality has presented itself. So the ox to the tiger to the rabbit, then comes forth the dragon. The dragon is black people. Black person's actual body. Then after the dragon comes the snake. The snake is the energy of black people. So that's black people doing their thing. You know what I'm saying? If you go back to the years, 13 and 12, whatever the case may be, black people, and then the year following was all of the hot shit black people was doing. So that's the black dragon is the black people's body, snake is the black people's energy, and then you go into the horse, which is another personality, expression. That's about boldness, stepping forth. Now understand, dealing with these years, you can be a victim of the energy, or you can be the victor. So now, the year of the horse started out with victims. Like Donald Sterling and all that stupidity about the basketball and calling dudes and slaves and, you know what I'm saying, all of that goof, foot in the mouth. Because their boldness put them forth in stupidity. So they was beat down and chastised by boldness. But then other people, in the proper mode, made special strides because they went forth in boldness. You can deal with all of this and break down prophecy to see what's coming forth just by understanding these Chinese animal zodiacs. As an understanding personalities that's coming forth. So now, after the horse comes the sheep. And that's this year, which has been very sublime. That's about etiquette and protocol. So long as you got the proper etiquette, you can do some real garbage, grimy shit. It ain't smooth. Then comes the monkey. Those are the 5 years I'm specifying that you need to pay attention to when they come into a cycle, so that you can set yourself up before they come into a cycle and big up during their time. That's the dragon, the snake, the horse, the sheep, and then the monkey. Monkey, as in monkey king. Monkey, as in people's champion. Monkey, as in class clown. Monkey, as in powerful force. Which is so powerful that they can be captured in their arrogance to think that they can't be dealt with. Because the monkey can't be dealt with, but it can be fooled and tricked into the box. and that's the next year coming up. So I just showed you the bad side and the good side. The monkey is powerful, but the monkey arrogance and clownery can get him captured. And then once he's captured, everybody that he was the people's champion for, those people could get demolished. You need to be aware of that. You need to seriously beware of that, because that's the year coming up right now. You know what I'm saying? After that, after the year of the monkey, come the year of the rooster, then the year of the dog, the year of the pig, and then the year of the rat. So you understand those cycles. But once again, you know what I'm saying? I personally, on a period, because life in this world is based on chess moves. People are setting down game for 50 years from now. And if you're still thinking from year to year, you're lost. So now, not to get too deep on people and make them think 50 years ahead. That's only for the people who think about immortality and immortal principles as a reality. But just, you know what I'm saying, to beware of those 5 years. The year of the dragon is when you know that you need to be putting it forth. You know what I'm saying? And then year of the snake is when, as black people, you need to be putting in the work, so that everything that you, it's almost like everything that you built up, now it's time to put the energy into it so you can see it manifest. So that's dragon to snake, and then comes horse. Because after you build something and put the battery in it, then you are bold, because you're like, yo, look at what I do, look at how I get down. See, it's a natural progression of common sense almost, but it's still a prophecy. It's crazy. So now, after you do such bold movements, that's the horse, followed up by the sheep. Because once you get too bold with it, you need to calm down, calm that down. That's the sheep. Now you're dealing with protocol and etiquette. You made those bold moves, now sit down and relax with that, relax with it, and see what's going on. As you see what's going on, you network and become sociable with others. You find out who's a bitch and who's not a bitch. And then comes the monkey, the people's champion. The one who's like, yo, those shenanigans is over.